In this video, we're going to discuss not just a database migration, but a colossal task Discord engineers took on, moving trillions of messages from one database to another. If you ever wonder what it takes to migrate data of such unimaginable scale, you're going to love this. Let's dive right in. I've been eager to talk about this topic ever since I joined Discord. The engineering culture there is dynamic and innovative. And this story is a perfect illustration of that. Though this is all from public information, the insights and takeaways are my own. Discord recently peeled back the curtain on how they migrated trillions of messages from Cassandra, the database that housed your chats and conversations, to SillaDB, a faster and more reliable alternative. The process was first shared at SillaDB Summit 2023 by Bo Ingram, followed by a detailed blog post. A big shout-out to Bo for presenting this complex process so clearly. So what did Bo share? I will summarize and share my own takeaways. You can watch his video and read his blog post if you want to learn more about it. Let's rewind back a few years. Discord found themselves in a bit of a pickle with their database choice. They were using Cassandra, but as the platform continued to grow, they faced serious performance issues. It took a lot of effort to maintain the main Cassandra cluster that held messages. The latency was unpredictable, and the frequent on-call incidents put huge strain on the team. By 2022, the Cassandra cluster held trillions of messages across 177 nodes. They knew they needed something different, but this message cluster was critical to Discord. If the message cluster is slow, Discord is going to be slow. If the message cluster is down, Discord is going to be down. Their solution? ZillaDB, a Cassandra-compatible database, but with a more powerful C++-based engine under the hood. Instead of jumping in headfirst to solve the riskiest and biggest problem, they started the migration with smaller databases. And this is my first takeaway. At Discord, the engineers move fast when mistakes are reversible. But if the solution is a one-way door, they spend a lot more time and care to get it right. They use these small migrations as an opportunity to test the waters and iron out as many issues as possible before tackling the big beast that held trillions of messages. Now let's talk about ZillaDB. It was written in C++ and promised better performance, faster repairs, and most importantly, it was garbage collection free. For a team that has so many issues with Cassandra's garbage collector, this was a breath of fresh air. The next key step was to create an intermediate layer between the API monolith and the database clusters. This layer is called Data Services. It was written in Rust, which is a safe and highly performance language, and it's a joy to write in Rust. The really cool idea about this layer is something called request coalescing. If multiple users request the same data, the database only needs to be queried once. This drastically reduced the potential for hard partitions. Imagine all those unintended add everyone messages in hugely popular Discord servers. With this layer in between, it is no problem for the database at all. Then they came up with the concept of a superdisk, the database cluster run on Google Cloud. When faced with the challenges of disk latency, they couldn't rely on the local NVMe SSDs on the virtual machines for their critical data storage due to reliability and durability issues. The alternative was Google Cloud's persistent disks. While it was reliable and flexible, it had the disadvantage of higher latency since they were network attached rather than directly attached. So what did Discord do? They went back to the drawing board and focused on creating a solution tailored to their specific needs. They chose to prioritize low-latency disk reads over all other disk metrics while maintaining the existing database uptime guarantee. What they came up with was a super disk combining the best of local SSDs and persistent disk at the software level. Their super disk was a two-layer RAID solution. They used RAID 0 to combine multiple local SSDs into one low-latency virtual disk, and then RAID 1 to mirror this RAID 0 array with a persistent disk. They then configure the Linux kernel to direct the write to the persistent disk, which has strong durability guarantee, and the read to the local SSDs, which offer low latency. This setup ensures low latency reads from the local SSDs and write durability from the persistent disks. What's so great about this? It's an excellent example of problem solving from first principles. Discord was dealing with a problem that had no ready-made solution. Instead of trying to make do with what was available, they redefined the problem based on their specific needs and then built a solution to match. The superdisk worked. At peak low, the databases no longer started queuing up disk operations, and they saw no change in query latency. Finally, with all this prep work done, it was time to migrate their largest database, the Cassandra Messages Cluster. With trillions of messages and nearly 200 nodes, it was a daunting task. But with a newly written disk migrator in Rust and some clever strategies, they managed to do it in just 9 days. Yes, you heard it right. They migrated trillions of messages with no downtime in less than 2 weeks. And the payoff? A significantly quieter, more efficient system. They went from running 177 Cassandra nodes to just 72 Zilla DB nodes. It drastically improved latencies and the quality of life for the on-call staff. It was no ordinary task, but with clever risk mitigation and innovative solutions, they put it off. So there you have it. I'm incredibly proud of what the team was able to pull off. Migrating a production database is no joke, and doing it at this scale, well, it is hard. If you like our videos, you may like our system design newsletter as well. It covers topics and trends in large-scale system design, trusted by 400,000 readers. Subscribe at blog.byebygo.com.